ये चलते हैं, वित्त मंत्री अरुण जेटली इस वक्त कलकत्ता में एक संबोधन कर रहे हैं।
माई फेवरेट मेमोरीज ऑफ हिम आर ऑफ अ पर्सन हु वुड वॉक इन टू माई स्टडी आफ्टर फिक्सिंग अ प्रायर अपॉइंटमेंट एंड इवन ऑफरिंग एन अनसोलिसिटेड सजेशन एंड द सजेशन ऑलवेज परटेन्ड टू वेर ही थॉट आई शुड मॉड्यूलेट माई स्टैंड ऑन सम इशू or rethink my position, or where things were going wrong and had to be put back on the track and some issues to be raised. And occasionally, he would carry a good book with him and said, I think this is a book you should be reading. And therefore, he would leave that book behind for us. Not very far away from mine, and very frequently, almost overlapping with various sessions of Parliament, if he was in Delhi, he loved to entertain people at home and would serve probably the most delicious vegetarian food which was served in Delhi. And I must share with you that Harsh today reciprocated his uncle's gesture by bringing in the same cook who used to entertain us in Delhi at his residence for Rajesh's afternoon. Successful people either in business or industry or in any other vocation including public life, there are always a few characteristic flaws that one needs to capture. And those with failings leave one or two behind. You need to capture anger. You need to get over jealousies. You need to overcome the temptation of being arrogant. You need to overcome the temptation of being overambitious. You need to overcome greed. And therefore, whether in politics or in industry or in any other profession, those who allowed any one of these four or five features to remain as a part of their temperament, eventually ending up paying some price for it. And there are very few who I have known who are able to almost capture all these. From jealousy to temptation to greed to arrogance to anger. And I think one person who would successfully pass this test was Suresh Nirutia. And today when he is remembered, he is probably remembered for these qualities that he inculcated in himself. I'm grateful to you, Chandrajit, for having invited me to speak in his memory on what I think India would be 4 years down the road. Well, I think 4 years is not a very long time in the history of this country. But 4 years are important because it will also determine the roadmap on which India is. And I think in order to determine our own roadmap, we have to look behind. And today, if we look behind the 67, 68 years post-independence, how do we analyze the decades that have passed? It's quite obvious that the initial years after independence for the government were challenging years. The private sector was very small. there are legitimately two views possible. That even in the initial years, while the government did concentrate on building a public sector and the economy around the state involvement in businesses, we should have been more open and liberal in allowing even private sectors to grow. But that's all that can be said with the wisdom of hindsight. And certainly one is willing to then give benefit of the doubt if you look back to those who governed this country in the first 2 to 4 decades after independence.
ये सीधा प्रसारण आप कोलकाता से देख रहे थे, जहां वित्त मंत्री अरुण जेटली सुरेश नौटिया के याद पर वो व्याख्यान दे रहे थे, लेक्चर दे रहे थे। और हम आपको बता दें कि सुरेश नौटिया का पिछले साल देहांत हुआ था। वो गुजरात अंबुजा सीमेंट के को फाउंडर यानी सह संस्थापक थे और वो उस गुजरात अंबुजा सीमेंट के अध्यक्ष भी रह चुके थे।